Hey there guys, ahoy there, it is Qwerty Afro. I'm bringing you actually a long awaited video. I'm really sorry that I actually didn't do this earlier when this game actually came out. I'm talking about TransOcean, the shipping company, a game that is, I would say, based on ports of call. Like, that's the kind of main game it, I think, is based on. It's very similar to Ports of Call. Obviously, this is, like, now set in the kind of modern time, and there's obviously, like, graphics, better graphics, you know, like, much more appeal, much more of a kind of a lookable factor to this game now that looks prettier and whatever. I played a good amount of it, and I've played some Ports of Call back in the day, and my analogy of it is that this game isn't as technical as Port of Call. It's very simple, but it's a nice little game. It's very nice, it's very beautiful to look at and play. And I thought, why not do a little campaign playthrough of it? I'll see how this goes. If you guys like it, I'll do more. Like, I'll release more at the, like, sooner. But if you're, like, alright about it, I might release, you know, a video from time to time of this game. It doesn't have to be a normal kind of video series. But we'll see what it is. As I said, I want to get into the shipping simulator genre. I did play a lot of Ship Simulator back in the day, like Ship Sim 2011. And then I think then Ship Simulator Extremes came out. But then it kind of got stale after a few years, nothing really happened to it. And then now there's going to be a new ship simulator, European ship simulator, which is coming out soon on early access, which I'll be definitely getting and making videos of, so stay tuned for that. But I thought to get into the kind of shipping mood, I'll, you know, do a little bit of a campaign playthrough of this game. Tell me what you think of the game below. I've done a bit of it as well on stream already, so some of you might already know about it. I already have, like, a game that I started, which is non-campaign based, which is pretty cool. But let's do a options. No way. Team. I think there is load saved game options. So it's a team. I'm sure there's a campaign mode. I'm very sure, because I started a game, just a plain game that you can start if you don't want to do the campaign. I've started a game. I don't want to go into that because I'd rather just start at the beginning for you guys. So let's just launch a new game. Low contract prices, a little startup capital, strict deadlines, high penalties, normal values, good startup capital, normal deadlines, normal penalties. Yeah, let's do just normal. Yeah, and then let's do the campaign. And let's start it. This game I've been looking at for quite some time while it was in development, and it looked really good, and it's delivered, but I expected a lot more. I thought there would be more stuff. It is very simple, and all the kind of reviews and kind of like feedback people have been giving is that it's very simple. There's nothing much to it. You kind of play it and you just have to keep playing it and playing it and playing it, and it doesn't really have anything to make you want to come back to it. Which is sad. I wish there was some sort of multiplayer in it. That would be really cool. But there is something of a multiplayer, but it's not like you play with actual people. It's that the people that play the game influence how the contracts and the kind of economy work in the game. That's the only kind of multiplayer side of it. Anyway, so let's get into this. Lydia Blythe Smith is an investor. So you want to start a company, then you come to the right place. My name is Lydia Blythe Smith. I'm an investor. Your contract appears to be in order. Okay. You're hoping to launch a shipping company. Even in these stormy economic times, well, I admire your determination. I'm prepared to back you with 8.5 million euros. It ought to keep you start up afloat. Why can you just say this could be enough to keep you going or something like that? Why this really bad English? Hemron T. Witherspoon. Hi there, Witherspoon's my name, and I'm your consultant and advisor. We can make this thing work together. So what's your shipping company going to be called? Qwerty Afro, that's a nice name. Also, by the way, the shoutouts, I really forgot to do the shoutouts free, sorry. Shoutouts for this video go to Mason, Fretz, and Catchstorm. That's again, Mason, Fretz, and Catchstorm. Their stuff and links and stuff will be down below. Give them some love. Those are the shoutouts again for this video. So let's get back into it. So I will call it Qwerty Afro is the shipping company. Or let's just do... Let's just do something I did in the other game I started. I did Qwerty Afro. Let's just get that. Oh, Qwerty Afro and Co. I like that. Qwerty Afro and Company or whatever. Great company. And where's your title, Little Empire, going to operate from? The first time in our business, location. I put together a few suggestions for these for the location of our headquarters. Boss, now, please decide where our future empire is going to start from. Well, I started before in Felixstowe. And I think Felixstowe is a very good port to start because it has quite a lot of export commodities. And it has a lot of different classes of ship you can get. There's other stuff here where there's other smaller ports which only have a certain type of ships and only a certain amount of commodities. There's only a very few amount of ports that actually have everything, like all the kind of ships and whatever. So I think it's Felixstowe that has all the ships, has a good amount of commodities. Rotterdam has all the types of ships. Hamburg only has three. Guataro has all of them, and actually quite a lot of, that's an interesting one to think about. Turkey in Ambarli Limani, very good as well, all the types of ships. Again, Port Said, really good in Egypt, very good. Algiers, only two, so not that good. Valencia, all five. I think just for the sake, again, I think I might just start it in Felixstowe because, you know, it's Britain, homeland. I'd rather start here. We have a good amount of material, post and parcels, timber or metal, machinery, medicine, radioactive materials and electronic. Let's just select it here. Oh, wow. I didn't actually know that there were cutscenes in this. Well, it's the campaign, obviously. I'll be quiet if there's any. I don't think they're speaking, but okay, no speaking. So I could have just spoke. Ah, Felix. So it's supposed to be quite nice here for tourists. That is, but for a newbie in the container shipping business, oh well, not my problem. Do you actually have any ships in your fleet? Oh, the tone is slowly getting tense, Chief. Not a good idea to joke around with her. Yes, I know. There are three models to choose from at the wharf right now. The investor has thrown enough money for us to afford one of them. Would you like me to introduce you to the game? I already know what to do in the game, so I'm just going to reject the tutorial. As I already know. Okay, so let's go to the shipyard and see what we have on offer. So we have a light carrier, a medium feeder, and a speed vessel. You have four different kind of things to worry about: max load, max speed, max range, and obviously the condition of the ship. What do we have here? We have 140 tons, 180 tons, 220 tons. Obviously, the smallest one is going to be the fastest one, but it can only carry 140 tons. Compared to, what's this, max range fuel, 10 days, 11 days, 12 days, okay, that is interesting. Normally I would tend to go for the middle one, but I might actually go for the smallest one, because it's the fastest, it has the best fuel efficiency, and it's in middle of condition, it's not too bad. I would go for the middle one, because it's actually not too bad. The only thing I'm kind of regretting is that it's quite a lot. 140 tons isn't really a lot, but then 220 is quite nice. But I'm not too sure. Lazy feeder ships are, yeah, equipped with their own loading crane and therefore can dock at ports without cranes. I think for now, I might just buy this little speed vessel. It's good. It's in good condition. It's going to save me a lot on fuel because it has quite a long, even though it's not that long compared, but, and it doesn't cost a lot compared to all these others, so I still have a little bit of money left over. Yeah, let's go for it. That's why not. Normally people would be like, oh, let's go for the biggest one, but I'm going to go for the smallest one because it's fast, so why not. So let's buy it. We will name it, and I think we are gonna. I'm gonna use the name Qwerty in front of all the names of the ships. So, the first ship will be called Qwerty. Let's call it Qwerty the First, because it is the first ship that we have. So why not Qwerty the First? It's not about christen. Let's christen the ship. Good, I guess now let's go and make some money. Pick up some contracts, ships and freight. What are you waiting for? Time is money. Okay, boss, now you need to hurry up and find a contract and get a ship to sea. I mean, we, of course. Yeah, cool. Also, this game has received a patch, which is pretty good. Some good changes, so hopefully the experience will be smooth and whatever. So here is our ship. It is, I can't zoom in right, oh, actually I can, but, okay, this is so far, but anyway, we'll zoom in once we get moving off. This is my ship, Qwerty the First. It is a very nice little small ship, and let's just get off and start doing some stuff. Company contracts down here haven't unlocked yet. I wouldn't even recommend doing them until you get a bigger ship, because I stupidly, in the other game that I created, started doing some of these company contracts, and I didn't realize that I couldn't really handle it because I only had one ship and one really small ship, and it couldn't handle the amount of I had to do so many jobs and I couldn't make it. I only got like up to, I only did like 60 or 70% of the actual full required load. So I'm probably going to leave out company contracts for a while. So here you have the finances. You can see how much we've spent or whatever, which we'll get into once we like go through a year. Ship status here, fill up or repair it. Repairing takes your ship out, so you can't use it for a certain amount of days. So do it only when you, I would only repair, I'm going to be very careful and not try and damage this first ship, because then once I get another ship, then I can send it into repair, so one ship can at least work simultaneously. And you have some like upgrades and stuff. I haven't actually messed around with this too much, but we'll get in this kind of let's play of this game. Right, contract list. Let's get going. Right, so there's different types of contract. There's it gives you the kind of days that you have to do. It gives you the money you will get for it. It gives you the kind of tonnage and obviously the location where you have to go. There's also this thing, this little green kind of like green plus icon with like some green people. That means that it's it gives you more reputation. There are some contracts that you can get from different parts, different harbors around the world, which give you a negative kind of reputation. Like say if you carry something like radioactive materials or whatever, it just gets looked upon as really bad, while all of these kind of nice good kind of cargo things are good for your company and give you a good reputation. Here you can adjust the speed of your vessel. So right now we have a 50 knots ship, so we can blast it at 50 knots. But then that reduces the time that the contract will be brought to its destination, but it drinks more of the fuel. That's one thing that we need to take in consideration. But I'm going to leave it at max power because this is a fast ship. I bought this ship to do fast things, so I'd rather just, you know, do it fast and just go over it. So right now we have two things to Hamburg, which is actually not too bad. But this, okay, that's not too bad. These two contracts, and it can actually, I think it can, yeah, it can fit in our heart, it can fit in our thing really nicely. There's two to Valencia. That is not actually too bad. I'm looking now at money because I want to obviously make more money, but let's just take these two to Valencia. Why not? We're going to make over $1 million on it if we get there on time, and we will get there with enough fuel. That's good, and I think that's alright. I would have gone for the Hamburg ones if it was just those two, but then when I scroll down and saw the Valencia one, let's just do that. It fits nicely in my ship. Good enough pay for it. Yeah, let's go for it. Let's accept these contracts. No longer shows this window. Yes, we're going to tick it. This just pops up if you don't tick at that to tell you what you're doing. But I'm going to tick it because we don't want to have it come up every time we do something. So right now, once that is done, we go on cast off. We are here in Felixstowe. We can click on Valencia to go to Valencia, of course. We're going full steam ahead, which is going to take about half of fuel, almost just under a half, which is good. Oh no, just over half of fuel, which is not too bad. As I said, I bought this fast ship because I want to do things fast. I want to make a quick buck fast. So let's cast off. Right, the kind of thing with this game is the kind of driving your ship out of a harbor, and it can be hard in certain places. So let's get going. This harbor's a bit weird to get out of because you have to kind of twist the boat out. If I can just move my ship a little bit. There's a little bit of lag issues when you zoom in a little into your ship, which is a bit annoying. But they've rectified it a bit. It was a lot worse when the game actually did come out. So and they've allowed you to zoom in like this close. Well, before it was much further out. But you can zoom out further out if you want to watch your ship. But right now I can start turning, I guess. But I'm just gonna. You're not allowed to go in this area, but I have to go in this area because there's no other better way of coming out of this harbor. Because we get parked up here, it'd be better if we get parked. So yeah, here now it's gonna warn me, say I'm in an unauthorized area, but the red area is the one that I don't want to be in. So once I pass the bay here, that's when I'm gonna start turning really sharply, increase the speed a bit. But then once I get enough, then I'm gonna reverse it and reverse the other way, like a car in a bit. But I'm not gonna say that these are the most realistic. I'm not gonna say these are the most realistic controls for a ship that I've used. They're definitely better ship control games and stuff like that. But it's nice. It's gonna have to be kind of arcadey than more realistic. But definitely, I like the kind of look of this game. The graphics are very nice. They're not the best, but they're very nice for this kind of type of game. So we're just gonna hopefully, yeah, we're good. I think we should be good once we get a full turn in. There we go, that's good. And then we can just go and full power it. We don't have to wait too much. There's other AI ships. The AI ships I'm not really impressed with. They're not really that good. There's not many of them as well. There might be just like one or two at most, maybe even three at most in like a harbor, which is annoying. It would be cool if a multiplayer does get maybe suggested for this game. I don't know if they. Oh, and there comes the really bad lagging once you zoom in. That's not. See, in certain angles, it's fine, but like say when I look at the back, it's really bad. So right now, when I look at the front, it's fine, but at the back, it gets really bad. So it's a little bit really badly optimized there, which is annoying. But there we go. We're heading off. This is what you have to do manually at each port once you leave a port, or if you want to come into a port. You don't have to do it. You can get a tugboat to do it. Like I can call a tug, but that costs money, so I'm not gonna waste money. Cool, we've done it. We've done no damage, and you get like a little kind of leaderboard to yourself of like your best times getting into a port and getting out of port. From here now, you're in charge, boss. Find the best contracts, bank the rewards, explore the most profitable routes, and keep an eye on your condition of your ship. My share is due the quarter after next. I'll be asking you for it promptly. I'm confident you'll do well. Work hard if you want to grow big. That's exactly how I made it. I'm very sure. We can also we can speed it up. We don't really. Oh, there we go. Let's dock. See, you can do a tug assist for 100,000, but I'm not going to lose 100,000 just to do something which I can do it. Some ports are a bit tricky to get into, I'm not going to lie. Some ports are like a little bit annoying to get into. But this one, okay, this one shouldn't be too bad. Let's get up to speed. I think they've changed the speed of the ships. Before, the ships used to go much faster, which kind of made it unrealistic. So I think maybe they might have tweaked the speeds of the ships a bit. because I think they were way, 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 way unrealistic in the first kind of patch of the game. And they, yeah, they definitely have. Because right now, I remember before when I drove the ship, it was much, much faster and it turned much faster. They've definitely made it a little bit, you know, more realistic, more like the way that the ships are traveling before were ridiculous. But I'm kind of just gonna do this as a car. I'm gonna kind of reverse and then go into that kind of space where I've been allocated. And you can see there another ship. They are actually, some of the ships later on get really big, and I mean really, really, really big. Like crazy, crazy big. Like, that's a medium sized ship. They're like ships that go maybe from the start of the bay to like behind this ship. They're big ships. This ship I have is very, very small. Very, very small. It is not a big ship. You can see how many containers that ship can carry, while my ship can carry maybe just a very small amount. I'm carrying, what, 100 and something tons? Those kind of ships maybe can carry over 10,000, 1,000 tons. Let's just turn up here. There we go. Ooh. Good, we didn't stretch it. That's good, that's good. There we go. Hopefully that's fine. And then we just stop nicely. Perfect. So we made quite a lot there. 1.3 million. That is really good. For a first trip, that is actually really good. No. That's just what I want to do. Your tub is a mess. We need to take a closer look. No, I'm fine. I don't need a tutorial. Why is it asking me again? Chief, we ought to leave this pitfall status of sole ship ownership behind us. If a shipping company is going to be successful, then we need to top up in a few fields. To get the next rank, we need the following. A better reputation, a second ship, a company contract with more capital. I'll explain that in order. Your reputation, for example, improves when you deliver deadlines on time. The other companies notice that you are a dependable partner, and the name of your company will get around. Yeah. So a deadline contract is not a bad thing. I can show you what. Yeah, I already know about this. This is the thing that has unlocked here that can give you like company contracts or whatever. Also, if we go back on the world map, you can actually have a look at your list of ships. Obviously here, so we only have one, Qwerty the First, and then we have fuel prices. Which you have a look at Europe and round. So right now, the cheapest price in Europe is Reykjavik in Iceland, which we're nowhere near. We're in Valencia right now, which is 6.29, which is almost coming up to being the most one of the most expensive places. And then you have, like, obviously Africa. I'm not sure if there's more ports around the world. I'm sure that there is more to unlock of the world map with different ports. I'm sure this is not it, because this is just like scraping Europe and North Africa. I'm sure there's going to be more ports or whatever. Right, let's it depends if we need to fuel up. I think Algiers is 532. If we can get a contract to Algiers, or if we can get, what's in Lisbon? Lisbon is, or even Lisbon. If we can get a contract to Lisbon, Algiers, how's Guio, 660. If we can get something to Lisbon or Algiers, because we don't have a full tank of fuel, that would be really cool. So let's go back here. Let's, because we have half fuel, and we're not going to make it anywhere long distance, so we need to go somewhere short distance to fuel up. So, let's go onto a contract list and let's see if we have anything for Algiers or... No, we don't. That is annoying. So, we have for Dublin, Guiotaro, Rotterdam. Okay, so Guiotaro is the closest one. See, I need to top up fuel, and that's really bad, because fuel here, Felixstowe has the most expensive fuel, so we're not going to fuel back in our hometown at all. Valencia 629, Guio is 669. What else do I have? Well, I can't really go anywhere else without refueling, so I think I am actually going to have to refuel here, because this is the cheapest option I have. Yeah, this is the actual cheapest option I have, because if I go back and if I look at the contracts that I have, I can't really make it anywhere except for Guiotaro, and in Guiotaro the fuels are more expensive, so I'm just gonna have to stick it up. And if I lower my speed, 29 days, that's not good, so there's no point of doing that. Let's see if I increase it a bit more. 19 days. Oh, minus 120. Oh, is that Stockholm? Oh shit, no, I wanted Reykjavik. Oh no, I thought that was Reykjavik for a minute, and then I realised that's Stockholm. A little bit stupid there. What's the next cheapest thing, actually, just to make it a bit more. What's Hamburg? 678. So I'm looking at Lisbon or St. Petersburg or something like that, because everywhere else is pretty much 600, so it's not going to be any difference. Rotterdam, no difference at all. We're basically just gonna have to refuel here, because there's nowhere else that's gonna be any different. So let's just refuel and let's have a look at the contract. Oh, and the contract list changed. No, it didn't change. Okay, let's just do I'm just gonna do these million contracts, because why not? Is there anything else? No, there's nothing else to Stockholm. I don't want to do anything to anywhere else. So we have that. So we have 102 tons left of fuel. Is there anything on the way we can do? No, we're just going to go cast off and go to Stockholm, I do believe, yeah. Cast off. It's cool, it gives you some information about each kind of. Okay, this is an interesting spot to get out of. I think we're gonna have to reverse it a bit, and then we're gonna slowly have to crawl out. If I can maybe slowly turn. Yeah, that's good. See, look how huge this ship is compared to mine. It's crazy. Right. Nicely does it. And it's moving as well, so I need to be careful. I can honk my horn. And maybe it'll honk its horn back. Hopefully I'll make this turn. I should make this turn. It's not a hard turn to do. There we go. Quite realistic dynamics here, some mechanics. The sound could have been better in this game. That's one thing that I'm a little. Ooh. There's me there, kind of almost crashing into the bay there, not paying attention. The sound could have been definitely much better in this game. I'm really annoyed that the sound's alright, but it doesn't really sound like ships, you know. It sounds just like really weird generators. And even though ships have like big diesel generators, it would have been better if it was a little better. Qwerty the First, our first ship in the Qwerty and Co. Qwerty Afro and Co. Yeah, they did really change. They did change the speed. They definitely did change the speed, because it's definitely much slower than before. I've put on. Let's do it on fast time. I have nothing to wait for. Manual, of course. Don't hesitate to sell old ships and yeah, whatever. Right, there's a cool trick for this port. I go in at full speed, and I don't know if it'll work with this kind of new top speed that they've changed it to, but we'll see. Yes, okay, I'm docking there. So I have to go at full speed, and then after a certain mark around, I think here, I do a full turn in. Okay, let's do that. And hopefully, if it still works, which I think it might not. No, okay, it doesn't. used to be for, like, you could just literally turn in and just go straight in like that, and you would swing in nicely. But I think they've really modified now the top speed of these smaller ships, that it's pretty much now hard and you have to do it slowly. I just managed to not scrape my ship because I'm really trying hard not to do any damage to my ships. Like, one thing I did in the game that I started, like the normal game by myself, I literally messed up my first ship so much that it actually sank at the end, which was really, really, really sad. I think it's emotional when a ship sinks. Perfect. Okay, we correspond to repair. Oh, we did 1% damage. Okay, that's bad, but that's all right. We still made almost 1 million, which is pretty good. So, that's actually pretty cool. Reputation improves. Boss serving deadlines could be good. Divid one cool. Build a positive reputation. Okay, no problem. I'm gonna leave it there, guys. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Tell me what you think down below about this game, if any of you've got this game, or if I should keep making more of these videos. It's you guys who decide. I only do my kind of my original, like, main games on this channel regularly, but then I throw in some other stuff from time to time. So if you want to see more, just tell me in the comments that you're interested for me to make more of these kind of videos of TransOcean, the shipping company game. The shoutouts for this video again were for Mason Fretz and Catchstorm. Their links and stuff will be down below. Show them some love. That's again Mason Fretz and Catchstorm. Like and favorite the video if you want to, and if you haven't subscribed and want to stay up to date with the videos I upload, be sure to subscribe. And yeah, if you're having problems with the YouTube module, like the Facebook page, I post the videos there all the time whenever I upload a video. Check out my socials, website, forums, or whatever, and I'll see you in another video. Bye, guys. We ain't never given up 'cause we ain't